Good day, everyone. Our topic for today is Introduction to Logic. The science of logic is the science of the reasonable. It teaches us how to think and acquire knowledge of the world in a sound and clear way. Logic thus connects us to the world. It makes the human mind vibrantly aware of its possibilities, that is, of logical possibilities. There is a need to develop the global skill and competence in making sound and rational arguments. This lesson helps us to understand what logic is and its importance to one's life. Hence, our objectives for this lesson are to define what logic is, explain logic as a science and as an art, and to appreciate the importance of logic in one's life. Logic is simply the science and art of correct thinking. We shall further understand that as we go on. Logic is considered an organ, meaning an instrument. It is an instrument for discovering and presenting truths. So, logic is not an end in itself, but an instrument for an end, and that is for discovering and presenting truths. It is through logical methods that sciences discover truths. So basically, science uses logic because logic employs methods which are very useful to scientific discoveries or scientific studies. The ability to reason is inherent to man. We have this so-called common sense. So as rational beings, it is expected that we have this common sense. That is why all of us have this natural logic in us, and this guides us to the use of fire, of water, of anything around us. However, common sense is prone to mistakes. That is why some others would say it is not really common. Hence, we need a systematized instruction on how to build up our natural talents and how to use them effectively. Therefore, we need the science and art of logic to develop the habit of confident reasoning. Now, let us discuss why logic is considered a science. Logic is considered a science because it is a systematic body of knowledge. Logic is a science because it is a body of knowledge that is systematically arranged and confirmed to be true. That is why we are learning about it, because it is a body of knowledge. And we follow procedures, we follow methods. Because logic is systematic and it is arranged accordingly. And of course, it is proven to be true. Logic as an art. Logic as an art. Or logic is an art because you have to develop the habit of doing something with a certain degree of order and harmony. So if you say art, it involves the skill of doing something. And of course, you can only develop such skill if it becomes a habit. So it becomes a part of your life. You do it regularly, you do it consistently. Further, logic is an art because it is a practical science which leads to the formation of the habit of thinking easily, orderly, and properly. So, as an art, it helps us, it helps men or humans to have that habit of thinking easily, so you won't find it difficult, orderly, that's why, because it is systematic and methodical, and of course, correct. Hence, we then say that logic is the science and art of correct thinking. And here, we have to define what thinking means. Generally, when we say thinking, it refers to any or to all the movements of the mind, such as imagining, recalling, memorizing, comprehending, analyzing, daydreaming, or solving problems. So, all of the activities of the mind are considered thinking. However, in logic, when we say thinking, we refer to inference. So in logic, thinking means inference. And when we say inference, that is getting a truth or conclusion from something formerly known to the thinker. So we can further understand this by having examples as we go on. And there are two kinds of inferences, inductive and deductive inferences. Inductive inference is drawing a universal or general conclusion from a series of individual interrelated facts. So this is from particular to general. So this is empirical in nature, because general conclusions are based from particular observations around. And deductive is the opposite, drawing a particular conclusion on the basis of assumed common or universal principles. So in here, there are universal or common principles assumed to be true or accepted to be true, and from those principles we can draw particular conclusions. So these are from general statements to particular statements, up to bottom. So we have examples here. All cats are animals. That is our first premise, our first statement. Felix is a cat. Our second premise. Therefore, Felix is an animal, is our conclusion. This is an example of a deductive inference. All cats are animals. Such premise or statement is based from the fact that all cats that we have seen, all cats that humans had seen, are animals. So from these particular experiences, particular circumstances, we believe that, or we draw the conclusion that all cats are animals. So that if all cats are animals and Felix is a cat, therefore Felix is an animal. So these two statements are the basis of our conclusion, Felix is an animal. So we infer from these two statements. So our inference has always a basis, or a basis. We cannot just infer, we cannot just conclude without any premises or basis. So this is what I was telling a while ago, that in inference, we draw conclusion from previously known facts or truths by the thinker. So the thinker knows that all cats are animals. He knows that Felix is a cat, so that he can infer that Felix is an animal. For example, for deductive inference, all salespersons are extroverts. Mario is a salesperson, therefore, Mario is an extrovert. It is assumed that all salespersons are extroverts due to the nature of their work, that they really have to talk, they have to convince people to buy their products. So this is the general or universal principle. It is assumed to be true. So if all salespersons are extroverts and Mario is a salesperson, we then conclude that Mario is an extrovert. So this is an example of deductive inference. We argue from the general principle to specific one. Now, why should we study logic? Why is it important to study logic? We begin our solution or answer to this question by observing that everyone obviously desires to know. Every one of us, every rational being wants to know. This self-evident assertion simply means that a human being is so constituted that he cannot help wanting to know. A human being is a knowing being. So we are condemned to know things. We are condemned to discover things. So we always have desire within us to question things and discover things around us. All human beings then, in varying degrees, want to know why things are so. One obvious sign that we experience is that kids often ask for why things are like that. Hence, we are insatiably curious. We question things, we want to know why things are like that, or why things behave that way, and so on. Logic then is a tool in helping us find out why things are as they are. And a good analogy is an axe. An axe is a tool for cutting down a tree. So that is obvious. An axe is an instrument to cut down a tree. But a sharp axe is an efficient instrument for cutting down a tree. So there is a difference from a sharp axe from the other axes, because a sharp axe is efficient. The power of thinking is an instrument for knowing the why and wherefore of things. But thinking sharpened by skill in logic is an efficient instrument for scientific knowing. So this is the very reason why we should study logic. We want to sharpen our thinking, our mind, our reason. So so that this thinking would become efficient as an instrument in our pursuit of knowledge.